Use of forms, queries, and reports. A table is the heart of any database because it contains the actual data. Other objects, such as forms, queries, and reports, are based on underlying queries. A form is an object that enables you to enter, modify, or delete data. The table has two views, the design view, which allows you to modify the looks of the table and the fields that are being used, and this is for the users to actually enter the data itself. And they also, and we also have the layout view, which is actually the table itself that allows the users to enter. You can just double click on the table, and there we go. We have at the bottom the navigation, which shows we have two records on this table, and we are looking at the first one. Also, in the attendance, we may have, let's say, a second entry for today, and today I was unexcused. You notice, so I navigate to the records, this gets updated too. If you look at our table attendance, there are the three records, two for me and one for John Doe. Sometimes we want to ask a question to the database to give us some records without giving us all the records from all the tables. To do that, we create a query. A query also has the design view, and this particular query is using two tables. Students, which has the primary key, which is the ID, and the student attendant, which has a reference called student ID, students.id. And you notice that we could have one student with many attendance records. Well, it will be more than one, obviously, because I will have an attendance for every day of class. That's what we call a one-to-many relationship. At the bottom pane, we have a list of the fields we want to retrieve. We don't want to see all the fields, because they could be too many. And if we have many tables referred, that will be a very large query. So we only select some of the fields, and we select the column, the tables, where those fields are coming from. Then we can also have a total or a sorting, ascending or descending, and we can show those fields on our query. Check or uncheck. A criteria or criterion, which is the plural, is simply a filter you want to apply. You don't want to retrieve all the records from a particular query or from a particular table. In this case, I only want to see the present. I don't care about the students who were absent. So if I were to run this, let's double click on it, shows me the students that were present. If you remember, I had one absence on excuse. So I go back to the design view, I'm going to change a criteria, which is simply a number, a text phrase, or an expression. I entered my, because it's text, I enter the text in double quotes, beginning at the end, and closed by double quotes. That will tell Access this is a text, and we'll know where it begins and where it ends. Let's save the changes. And there's one. I can retrieve all the records if I wanted to. I can click save so it doesn't ask me when I X out. And then I can run it. And you see there are three. Sometimes we want to make this a better looking result. So what we'll do is create a report, which is a professional looking formatted information from any tables or queries. This particular query was used to build a report, the student's attendance by date. And basically, this report also has a design view and a layout view. Don't get confused by all these symbols. We'll talk later how to create your own report. And you can actually run the report. You can just double click on it. And you notice by day, first day I was present, the second day was one on excuse and one present, and gave me some totals. Similar way is this. Now it's grouped by the status, all the ones that were absence on excuse, which I will use, will be on the top, and then who was present on the bottom. Now, if you remember when we were looking at the queries, I was making changes. It kept asking me in the design view. It kept asking me. I'm looking at the tables. I'm sorry, and the query. It kept asking me if I wanted to save the changes. Well, because I'm making some changes in memory. I'm not making the changes in the hard drive yet. That is, Access wants to make sure that this is what I want, and I didn't make a change by mistake. However, if I'm entering, if I'm on a table and I'm modifying information here, for instance, I want the student ID to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't want to be hidden safe of every time I change a field. Focus is where the cursor is at right now, and if you notice, there's a yellow border to indicate which row and which column we are editing or about to edit. In this case is the home phone in the second line. If I exit out, you notice I changed the ID number. I X out, and if I want to go back, the ID number is there. That is because Access automatically saves the data for you. One thing we are concerned in any database is how long does it take to get some data out. Retrieve records. That's what we call it, access speed, which means the time it takes for the storage device to make the file content available for use. If we go to the attendance table, you notice there are three records. And let's say I delete the second record. You notice physically in the hard drive, these three records most likely are next to each other, like you type contiguously in a piece of paper. However, when I remove a record or modify a record from the middle, let's say, the remainder records are not moved up to utilize the space that the deleted record was using. This will leave gaps in the database, leaving blank spaces. So what we want to do is compact our database after time and repair it. So we go to this Database Tools tab, click on Tools, and we click on Compact and Repair Database. What this will do is create another database, go to the tables, and copy record by record so they are in sequence with next to each other. And then first, old database gets deleted, and the new database is renamed with the old name. You should back up your database also. If you are at work and this database is on a network, most likely there's a person from your IT department, just like me, who will back up this data periodically. In case something happens, you can refer to a backup and restore it. However, if you are at home, most likely don't have that, then you will probably want to save your database periodically in a flash drive or a CD, just to keep a second copy. Go ahead and try the hands-on exercises of page 79, and we will talk about filters in the next video.